Hey, chef, did you start your culinary career thinking, well, within 5 years, I'm going to own a restaurant of my own, and you're still in the same place? If that's the case, you're kind of like that woman who every spring tells everyone, this is going to be the year I'm going to fit into my summer bikini. And we're all guilty of judging this woman because most of us are thinking, look, either take some action or just stop fooling yourself, okay? So, I want to ask you, Chef, how many years are you going to let go by before you start calling your own shots? I want to share with you six myths that chefs tell themselves that keep them stuck. But before I do, I want you to know my name is Holly Powers Burbeck. And for over 23 years, I've been helping chefs call their own shots and elevate their lives and careers through their own business ownership. In short, I've been helping chefs start and run their own culinary businesses, and I'd love to tell you a little bit more. So, here are six myths chefs tell themselves that keep them stuck. The first myth is, oh, before I can take any action, I need more education, I need more credentials, I need more experience. The truth is, if your cooking is good and you're ready, now's the time to start taking action. Nobody said you had to give up your job yet. You just need to start taking action. The second myth is, I don't have enough money. I need to meet an investor. That's for somebody who's thinking about a restaurant. But the truth is, we all know that if unless you've got $2 million, a restaurant's really a long shot. There's so many things in between working a kitchen job and running a restaurant. And I'd love to share with you more about that because there are even ways that chefs can be far more profitable than you'd ever be in a restaurant for less effort. The third myth that chefs tell themselves is, I don't have the time, or now's not the right time. Chef, you have the same 24 hours a day that I have, and it's all about how we prioritize ourselves in anticipation for the future that we want to live. The fourth myth people tell themselves is that others won't approve. Many of us are afraid what others will think, what they'll say, or we're waiting for permission. But the truth is, if you've got something that's longing to be born from within you that needs to come out, now's the time to take action. Another myth that chefs tell themselves is, first, I need to conquer my own fears, or once I gain the confidence. And they have this idea that the longer they stay in the back of the house, the more confidence they'll get. You won't gain more confidence running a business by staying in a kitchen job. The way you gain confidence is by doing the thing that you're not confident in. So that's just a myth, Chef. And the sixth myth, yeah, the sixth myth that chefs tell themselves that keeps them stuck is that there's a really big list of to-do items that needs to be completed for you to start. I had a chef call me and he said, well, I'm working on my employee handbook now. And oh my God, when he said, I'm working on my employee handbook, and that thing's going to be out of date in 3 months. And you don't need an employee handbook to start business. Did you know that the employee handbook for Nordstrom's for decades was be good and do the right thing, or some version of that? Like it was a page. So the big list that you think that there is that needs to be completed before you can start a business, I would challenge you that it isn't at all what it is. So here's the answer. In order to not be stuck, in order to finally fit into that bikini and to start running that business of your dreams that you said you wanted so many years ago, is to simply start. You've got to take some sort of action. I want to tell you, there are kids that are opening up lemonade stands in moments and getting out on the curb and getting money in their hands within moments. And every day I read posts on Facebook groups about chefs. Holy cow, the number of chefs who say, I had it up to here, I quit my job, it's been 2 weeks, now my schedule is booked and I'm making more than I ever have. I meet these chefs every day. And chefs have been running their own businesses for centuries. You're not reinventing the wheel here. People need people who can cook. So this isn't genius work here. This is just knowing how and when to take the right steps. So you should also be taking strategic steps to build this business that allows you to call your own shots. When you take small steps and follow somebody else who's been exactly where you want to go, not any business coach, but somebody who can coach you in the business that you want to run and achieve, then you'll have strategic steps that can get you where you want to go faster than you could get there on your own. And the example that I have has to do with where I live. I live in Truckee, California, near Lake Tahoe. And the Donner Party is famous for this area. I don't know if you know them, but in 1863, two-thirds of them died trying to get to San Francisco. And that's because they thought they would take a shortcut. They said, oh, we've got a better way. We can do this on their own. They followed somebody who wasn't trustworthy and didn't have a record. And they ended up paying the ultimate price for it. So I want you to make sure that you know there are strategic steps that you can take that are low risk, low cost, and that taking action is the most important thing for you to do. Chef, the reality is, if where you are now with your work isn't where you want to go in the future, and it doesn't give you the chance to get there, then what you need to do right now to get what you want most in your life is to start taking action. Because there is nothing more painful in life than letting your dreams collect dust and not taking any action. How many years are you going to continue to let trickle by before you take steps to build a future of your own that you've been dreaming of for your entire life? Chef, if this video has been helpful to you in any way, I encourage you to like, comment, or share it. And hop on over to my website. I've got a lot of free resources available to you. There's also some workshops that'll help you start taking the next right step toward your brighter future, running a private chef or a personal chef business.